I want to move to the thorny issue of the Middle East, and we've all saw what happened right after the U.S. moved their embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. There were huge protests on the Gaza border. We all understand that Hamas is considered a terror organization by Canada, and they were, of course, instrumental in some of those protests. Nonetheless, Israel and Israeli forces shot and killed over 60 people. Thousands were wounded, including a Canadian doctor who was shot while he was trying to provide medical assistance. Justin Trudeau is calling for an independent inquiry. Israel has now rejected, but he did say this is an inexcusable and excessive use of force. Peter MacKay, did Justin Trudeau go too far or not far enough in his comments on the situation?
I think he went a little far. Calling for the independent inquiry is one thing, but framing it as inexcusable excessive force, I think predetermines what any kind of a report might say. Now, there's going to be lots of other calls for similar examinations of the fact, but let's go back to basics. As you said, Hamas is a banned terrorist organization in our country and in many countries, many Western allies around the world, and they are behind this protest. Why were they bringing human shields? Why were children being brought to a zone where there was expected to be this type of response? So complex in the extreme, but highly predictable in terms of what happened here. And Hamas are very much to blame and have this blood on their hands.
Okay, well Joyce, I've spoken to the Israeli ambassador. There are real questions about how they determined to use that kind of force. What's your view? You reported for many years from that region.
Yeah, let me quote Bernie Sanders. You know, Gaza is a humanitarian disaster. They get electricity 4 hours a day. Their hospitals are, a mess. They probably did not have what they needed to treat the people that were wounded. So I know the easy kind of American and Israeli line that this is all on Hamas, but these are people that have nothing left to lose as well. So it is a perfect storm. Gaza is a perfect storm on the best of days.
So was Justin Trudeau right to call it an excessive use of force? Was he right to call for an independent investigation?
Well, is it an excessive use of force? So let me ask perhaps the former, foreign affairs minister, is opening fire with live bullets against a mostly unarmed, a demonstration, an excessive use of force? And if that's not, then perhaps define it for me, because I think it is an excessive use of force.
Craig, you weigh in and then we'll get back to Mr.
Well, do you know that they were unarmed? That's my first question. Do you know that they were unarmed? And do countries have the right to defend?
Do you know that they were all armed, though? Do we know that?
Do they have the right to defend themselves against armed forces coming into their country uninvited? No country would be expected to allow that to happen.
But that's not what happened, and we all know it.
I had not heard that anyone was shooting at the Israeli army.
Yeah.
I hadn't heard that.
This is obviously an extremely complex situation. I think our conversation shows why there should be an independent investigation into this. But I think to me the most striking element of this situation is how different the liberal and conservative lines were on this situation in Canada. We had the conservative leader Andrew Scheer siding completely with the United States and putting all the blame on Hamas. We had Justin Trudeau calling for this independent investigation, using this term excessive force, siding with Theresa May and the UN on the independent investigation front. So I think
condemning it wholeheartedly.
Exactly.
Condemning Israel wholeheartedly.
Right. So I think we saw quite a divergence here on the domestic front of how these two main leaders have dealt with the situation.
All right. That's all the time we've got this week.